Okay, folks, friends, subscribers, and anybody that believes in UFOs, well, and people that don't believe in UFOs, well, in a minute you're about to see a UFO that was captured by three NASA stereo cameras, three separate cameras, and also two different times, similar spacecraft observing. What you're seeing, if you watch this, and I strongly advise you to watch this in full screen. That craft that you're seeing there, you're seeing it entering the atmosphere. In the blow-up pictures of the shots, you'll notice like a shield or something around it as it's going through the chronospheres of the sun, and as it's entering and looking at everything to do with the sun. It looks like it's actually changing shape. I don't know whether it's one of the morphing type craft that we've seen, but this craft is massive, folks. This craft would have to be at least twice the size of Jupiter, if not larger, again. And it's going extremely close to our sun. Now, if you notice, that's not an orbit. It's going past it, as if it's deliberately setting itself up and going past the sun. Now, as I said, you'll see this in a larger thing. Now, this is the stereo behind. Now, in a second, you're going to see the stereo ahead camera, which is the camera on the opposite side from where we're looking now. This and it, but it picks it up actually a little bit earlier on the stereo ahead. It picks it up actually around about the 29th of December. I think, yeah, there he is, 29th of December, it picks it up on the stereo ahead. Now, you've got to remember, it looks like it's coming from a different direction. Now, notice all those anomalies. I call them light ships, and you'll see them at the end. I'm going to discuss them at the end, and in another video, I'm going to discuss them in a great detail. But here's the craft. Now, this is, it seems to be closer to the stereo ahead camera. But notice that shape change. It is still changing its shape. Now, at first I thought, yeah, well, it wasn't, it was just something weird. But the more I looked at it and the more I enlarged it and everything, and yeah, it's still changing shape. So I thought, wow, this is quite odd and quite weird. So this is actually being caught by the stereo head. In a second, we're going to be seeing it from the Core 1 camera. But notice the dates. This is January, folks. But notice the dates on the Core 1. See, in this period, it wasn't caught by the Core 1 cameras in January. But in March, which is happening right now, because it's actually still passing our sun, and it's still observing our sun. And basically, not long after our sun started to do a shift, which is another video that I'm currently preparing, but I'm just waiting for the NASA to clean up the data a bit. Hopefully they will, but actually proves my moving sun theory. But what you're seeing here is the Core 1. I've ran it from similar dates so that there is a sort of a correlation to it. Now the Core 1 is Core 1 behind. So it's going around about the same period of time as the Core 2 behind, and it's appearing very similarly. You've just noticed that flash. Here it comes now, and you'll see it, but this is what gets me. I thought, hang on, why is this at this distance? But then I remembered the Core 1 is a blow-up. But then I thought, hang on, no, something else. So I believe what we're actually seeing here is actually the same image, but just distorted a bit because it's on a close-up of the sun and everything. It just looks a little bit weird, but it's still questioning this because it is a different light spectrum. So this could actually be another object picked up in a different light spectrum. But this one's heading directly towards the sun. That's where the weirdness gets to it. But then I get to the second image. Now, this is not the January image. I accidentally put these back to front, so I apologise to that. But when we get up to the core 2. Now, you notice it still hasn't come out the other side of the sun yet, and that's queering me. Now, I won't know for a few days, okay? It's going to be most probably about another week before I can update this particular section of the behind core 1 in regard to that craft. But then when we get up to the core 2, it's quite obvious. It's but notice how they're blocking the data. Now, here we go. We just saw something leave the screen, which was that same type of craft. But for some unknown reasons, it's missing before the 12th. But here it is, a similar craft. It's not the same craft. It's very similar in shape. But it's moving a little bit faster than the other craft was. Actually, it's moving about twice as fast as the other craft was. And this one's actually doing a few things. And you'll notice that it's changing and moving around. Now, that flash there was actually because a solar flare actually flashed the stereo camera. But you're still noticing all those little flashing anomalies that are happening. Now, notice here, NASA's trying to cover it up here for some unknown reason. Now, this is one of the March anomalies. I call these the light ships. This is the January craft. These are blow-ups of the craft. And I took them in stages. The January craft, I took a lot more as it was closer because the shape got me. And I looked at the shape, and at first I thought, nah, that can't be. But then I noticed what looked to be propulsion jets coming out of it, and then all of a sudden the propulsion jets disappeared, and that's when the shape of the craft came into realisation that I was actually looking at a spacecraft. But then it's the morphing effect. I didn't know whether it's because of the sun, but notice that type of field around it. Notice the rear of the sun. Now you can see some kind of field, what looks to be a field, but that's actually the sun. That lighter yellow is being created around, but there's some kind of a field still around the craft. But the yellowing is the sun's jets pushing out on it as if it's the magnetic sphere of a planet, say. But this is a ship. It's the same thing happening with a ship. But whether this ship was designed especially for this to happen to it, I don't know. But you can see the shape of the ship is actually changing. With the January craft. These are progressional images with the January craft as it's going across the screen. And you notice the field generated behind it. It's definitely not a planet. It's not a star. But, again, it's starting to go into more than a ship. But notice that field being generated in front of it as it's going away. And then I realised, okay, that's the sun pushing crap. But then I thought, no, hang on, this is actually surrounding it. And they look to be propulsional jets. Now, then the March craft comes through. Now, notice that beam that's coming up. That's actually pretty weird because it's pretty, I wouldn't say constant, but one minute it's there, one minute it's not. But notice that same type of field generated by the sun's winds, but also looks like it's being generated by the craft itself. Then notice the beam emitting from it, and I can't work out what that beam is. Now here's the same March craft caught on the on the core 1, and yeah, it was quite amazing to actually see it being crammed. That's one of the anomalies I found during just before that image. And you'll see in a second another shot of the ship, but with a light ship going past it, because it's got to be a light ship because it's only appeared in one image. And but there's the March craft in the core 1, core 2, and yeah, so it's quite amazing to actually see. Now these are light ships. I call these light ships because you only see them ever in one image. And that's the thing that gets me, because the fact that they're only there in the one image. Now, note, this is extremely close to the sun with that March craft, and there's an anomaly appearing near the March craft. And so there's something going on. Now, the next couple of images, you can see that they're trying to cover something up there. Now, this one gets me, because I'm going to talk about that image in another video, but there's some of the things that I took out and blew up. Now, notice the multiple craft in there, whether they're actually shots of the same craft, moving at extremely high speed, but they're not being blurry, so I think they're actual multiple craft travelling on the same path. And I believe they have something to do with sun dogs. I'm extremely theoretical in regard to that. Now, that's a craft fairly close to the actual camera. And notice that they're travelling in always travelling in similar directions. So, but they're moving extremely fast. And I mean extreme. You can see the motion blur in some of these. Now, these are captured in split seconds. Yet, in some of the images, you get a little bit more clearer images. And in the next one, made me think, okay, some of them I know are craft. Because, now, look at those triangular-type craft. You can tell they're spacecraft. But the others, are they some kind of weapon? But then I thought, no, these are actually craft travelling in the same direction. So, and this is a repeat of the video again, and sorry, I didn't want to take that out, but you'll see here in a second the craft appearing. This is in the January, so between the behind image and the ahead image, it was captured by the ahead image, we'll know in a minute, about 6 days, 7 days prior. So the ahead caught it 7 days prior to this one appearing. So as you can see, now for a craft to be moving this fast, not even a planet moved this fast. We have no orbiting planets that are orbiting our sun at these speeds. Because this is in a matter of days, folks, and I mean days. And we don't have any planets that orbit our sun within days. They take quite a large period of time to actually go past and orbit our sun and everything like that. You would see them in more of an orbitalytic pattern, where our planets are actually harder to see. You won't see Mercury because Mercury is 100% hidden by the black spot. Venus, you would only ever see little peaks coming out in front of those that black spot. They'd be still fairly close. Yeah, so you've got to think, what are they? What are these things actually travelling past our sun? And there is definitely something travelling past. Now, if you look at it, that's a dead straight line. That is not an orbitalytical pattern. And as it comes off the page, you'll notice that the further away from the sun that it gets, and it does, I believe that mass coronal mass ejection is basically causing by that. But here's the craft coming across on their head too, and this is back in the 29th, and there's all those anomalies that I was talking about at the end. You can see it was caught earlier by the ahead camera. So basically, here it is. You can notice the same shape changes happening on this camera, but notice that it's actually lower. And it's more, and you can actually notice it's actually that slight bit larger. So therefore, it is on this side of the sun, rather than the behind side of the sun. Now, as I've shown you in my other rogue planet video in regard to the stereo, it's like Earth. Earth is home plate. First and third are stereo and behind. And it's sort of like a baseball field, and second base isn't used yet. They most probably will eventually use second base. It'd be nice to actually see the Earth appear in these videos. But the thing is, we've got to look at it and say, okay, what is actually truly going on here? We have something going on with our sun. Now, these are the core behinds. Now, the reason why I have left the section of the core behind, core one behind in thing. Now, watch the right-hand side of the screen. You will start to see what looks to be someone throwing rocks in the pool. And it's like, as you see, if it's magnetic waves affecting the light span, I'll actually tell you when I see them. But they're little ones. You can see them happening going out, but every now and then, there's one just happened there on the right-hand side of the screen. They're only faint, but if you're watching this in full screen without any white light around, they'll be a bit more obvious. I will be discussing them in greater detail in another video, as I have quite a lot of footage, about most probably 50,000 images of that. But here's that craft, which I believe has something to do with those. Notice that magnetic interference appear just as this craft is coming through. But this one is heading directly to the sun. And again, this is moving 3 day, most probably in a 3 to 4 day ratio from the time that we see this. This is too large to be Mercury, too large to be Venus. Again, this is most probably about twice the size of Jupiter. It could be larger than than twice the size. It could be most probably up to four times the size of Jupiter, but it would not be under two times the size of Jupiter, as you can see there now. It's coming through, and I don't think it's actually coming in front of the sun on this time. I believe it's on the ahead side of the camera, because on the ahead side, around about the same date, there was a bit of, as if there was an eclipsing type effect. I had a bit of, I don't know why, but I'm having dramas downloading the ahead side of it for some unknown reason. I'm trying to work out whether it's just a problem with the data or something, but generally they do fix it, and I should be able to get it, and I'm going to put that into the next video in regard to updating what's going on here with the spacecraft. Again, you can see the crap happening there in both the core one and everything, but as you can see, there was a craft just leaving the screen in that one, but now we have another craft coming across. So it's definitely not a planet, because this craft is coming across in the same one as the other image that was thing. It's moving extremely fast, too fast to be a planet, so therefore it can only be a ship, folks. And you can see little like object dars coming off it, whether I believe they could be thrusters, but you can see fields being created. That white flash there was actually caused by the sun flaring out towards the stereo ahead camera. Now, as the craft moves along, but moving towards the date, that's the sort of dramas that I'm having. Now, this is what I call one of the light ships. There's the January craft. And as you can see, it's definitely a triangular craft in shape as it first comes through. You can see what looks to be... yeah, I'd say side jets, thrusters happening. The thrusters are killed, but you still see something actually happening. You see the more the shape of the craft here as it's coming in, and the shape of the craft is still there. Now, as it's going through, now I liken this to how we send probes to the Jupiter, how it had that disc at the front that was meant to break down. Now maybe this could have something similar on it. As the longer it goes through, the more of the disc is torn away, until the spacecraft, minimal spacecraft, is left. I don't know, but I noticed that as it goes past the sun, but it does tend to get a bit of a shape back at the end, whether this is just the craft moving in a slight angle to actually protect itself. And you can see what look to be thrusters in that shot. You can see the dome at the back. You can see the field around the craft in this shot. So there's a lot of things happening. You can see, what look to be thrusters in here. What looks to be shields and some kind of field in front of it. So there is definitely something going on with this craft. You can see like a magnetic field being generated in front of it. And what even looks to be a little bit of pixelation around it in these images that NASA look like they may have actually been trying to cover this one up. But as the further it goes through, you can still see that it's still coming through. But notice around it, there's no pixelation. So hence NASA is actually attempting to cover this up. They must think that no one's going to actually go in and get the big images and then zoom them down and crop them. That's what I do. I get the biggest images I can before I crop these images, but I still get generally reasonably good pics out of it. Now, this is one of those light ship anomalies. Now, notice the multiple craft, and they're on a curve, so they are not traveling in a straight line. There's one of the craft. There's a little bit of a field coming behind it. Now,
that little field that was dropped behind that other craft, I saw them in some of the NASA actual videos, which I'm going to chop up and show you in further videos when I come to getting more information in regard to these light ships. But the more and more I look at these images, there's definitely something going on. There's definitely something happening. Now, these March craft are still around our sun. This is currently, to us, it would be at the side of the sun. So if you do have cameras, and remember, this is Jupiter-sized, so it could be picked up by cameras. So get out there and get your cameras active. See if you can pick this ship up by your cameras. Now, this big white flash, that was something actually going past the camera. I've had flashes where it's like weird shapes coming past that always wind up like the shape of these light craft. I left that in there for a reason, because that was a genuine shot by the telescope. And it's one of, and it's because one of those things came very, very close to the camera. Now, notice that image in there. Now, that was something heading towards the sun. Again, that's, I'm waiting for more data before I put that one out in regard to another one coming, showing up on the Core 2. But it hasn't moved across the sun far enough yet to put any data. Now, in the next one, you can still see these craft moving extremely fast, but it's this image that I love. Look at them. You can definitely see spacecraft. There is definitely something going on. So anyhow, this is Anthony Avery signing off once again.